Alrighty, welcome to another Mirrodin flashback draft here on channelfireball.com. Ooh, Imperial Plate. Pretty good bomb rare here. 2 to 2 to cast, 2 to equip, and will frequently give +3/+3 to +4/+4 or +5/+5, some large sum. So we'll be taking Imperial Plate over Detonate, Arrest, Aether Spell Bomb, and some mirrors. For those of you who haven't heard me go off in this format, the mirrors, there's one for each color. Very, very important because they're mana acceleration, creatures that can carry equipment, and color fixing. So we'll still be taking Imperial Plate. Mirrors being great does not change that. Oh, well, those who watched my first draft also know how much I like Skeleton Shard. I think this card is very good. And likely I'm going to take it over Somber Hoverguard and Iron Mirror. I do like cards with names like this, though. Troll Shaman, good creature type. In any case, Skeleton Shard is very important. You can get a lot of, or very powerful, you can get a lot of artifacts. And, yeah, just trade off, get cards back. Iron Mirror, very good. Somber Hoverguard, quite good, but I just love Skeleton Shard. It's just one of my favorite cards, and I think it's really sweet. Ooh, Luminous Angel. 7 mana, 4-4 flyer. Gets you 1-1 spirit every turn. Card's not that good. Just 7 mana cards are not that good in this format. And if I'm saying that, you know they're not that good. I like Goblin Upka a lot. This card's a fine card and very good at Skeleton Shard. Repeatable artifact kill. So, plus, they're both easy to splash, so we will be taking the Goblin Replica here. What do you got? Ooh, Shatter's a good one. Chromatic Sphere is also pretty good. Frogmite's not bad. I think I'm probably just going to take Shatter, though. I'm always happy to have this card in my deck. I already have a red card. Feet Spinner is kind of interesting. Your opponent gets to skip one of, or has to skip one of their turn, their phases, but it is not something I want to take over Shatter. Also, a little shout out to Farsight Mask, which I'm probably going to wheel, if we're being honest. All right, what do we got next? Chromatic Sphere isn't bad. I like Pirate Spellbomb. Given they already have two red cards, kind of attracted to Spellbomb here. Goblin Dirigible. There used to be a rule, DDD, don't draft Dirigible. This card is just pretty bad. Just having to pay for it on top of it is a big drawback. Gate to the Aether. Nope, we'll not be taking this. All right, Pirate Spellbomb, that is. Ooh, now I can take Chromatic Sphere. I think I like taking Chromatic Sphere over Thought Cast. I do like Thought Cast in general, but I think given that I have three red cards, kind of a half black card, I think I'd rather just take the Sphere here. Don't mind Clockwork Condor, especially with Skeleton Shard. Flyers are good with Imperial Plate too. Probably just going to take Wizard Replica though. I'm a big fan of this card. Just kind of cheapish flyers. Three's not like super cheap, but it's not too expensive. Carry equipment well, like Imperial Plate. Its ability is also more useful than you might think, and it's good with Skeleton Shard as well, so we'll be Wizard Replicaing. And look, I've got 6 artifacts already, which is a good start if I pick up some cards that care about artifact. Ooh, Rust Elemental. 4 mana, 4-4 flying, and it eats all your other artifacts. Good to Skeleton Shard as well, but I think I'd rather just take, well, it's either Pewter Golem, Moriak Scavenger, or Slifespark Spellbomb. Scavenger's not bad. In a deck that's built around Skeleton Shard, Scavenger's going to be pretty good, I think. And I like it a little more than Pewter Golem for that reason, especially since I've got incentive to be playing some swamps and whatnot, though I'm not locked into colors by any stretch. Ooh, that's a late Aether Spellbomb. That's a nice pickup. Spellbombs are really good in this format. There's just a lot of cards that care about artifacts. These replace themselves. You can just always draw a card with them, and then their effects that you sacrifice them for are actually quite good too. Deal 2 or bounce a creature are both good effects to have. I'll take a Tree of Tales. All right, I've set up for Affinity Deck. I've got tons of artifacts, so no heavy color commitments. This is how I tend to draft Mirrodin. I think how you should draft Mirrodin. You basically aren't committing to much. Ooh, now I'll take the Condor. Makes me happy I took Wizard Replica earlier. And this way I can play like, you know, Mirror Enforcer, Somber Hoverguard if they're good. No, none of the mirrors came back. I didn't get any late mirrors. Maybe people are picking up on that. And if I open, you know, just powerful cards of a particular color, like I've got a Skeleton Shard and a Moriak Scavenger in terms of black, Shatter, Pirate Spellbomb, and Goblin Replica in terms of red. So not a whole lot. Ooh, I do like Farsight Mask a lot, and it was good in the first draft I did, the first throwback draft I did, which was sweet. I kind of like Narok Familiar with Imperial Plate and such a high artifact density, so I think I'm just going to take that. I'll take Will of the Nim as a sideboard card. And take another Will of the Nim, why not? This is not the secret to this draft format, let's just put it that way. And Slagworm Armor. Nah, I played this card before. I played every artifact in this entire block that costs 1 mana. That's not even an exaggeration. Just sometimes your sick affinity decks just want a Tangle Bloom to make it so your 3 Mirror Enforcers and 2 Somber Hoverguards are cheaper. Okay. Well, this is a bad pack, except it's got a Mirror Enforcer, so I'll be slamming that here. Trash for Treasure, sweet constructed card. Fabricate, also a sweet constructed card. More trolls, always trolls. Lifespark Spell Bomb, but yeah, this looks like it's time to take Mirror Enforcer. Let's put it by the proper curve. What do we got here? Ooh, Leonin Abunus. This card was actually just like a straight up bomb. You get to play this and make it so none of your artifacts are targetable. Not a whole lot else here. I could take Abunus and splash it. That's not out of this world. There's like Vault of Whispers is the alternative. I might just take Abunus here. This card is really, really absurd. I mean, I think it's better than Arrest by a decent margin. And now we've got, well, I guess, another Shatter, because I'm pretty good chance I'm playing red here. Barden Blood is a cool card, but not a card I care too much about. I like Mirror Retriever, especially with Skeleton Shard, Infinite Loop, but I'm happy just taking Shatter here. Ooh, now I gotta take Iron Mirror. There is Somber Hover Guard, but I don't know what colors I am. And I think there's a pretty good chance, like, I end up maybe cutting most of the black. Nope, I don't want you to move. Stupid. And either splashing Abunus or probably not splashing Narak from it. I don't know, but Iron Mirror is perfect. I need mirrors. I have all red cards, so it's going to work out quite nicely. Jeez, Viridian Shaman. This card's also just a ridiculous bomb. And there's Leaden Mirror and Talisman of Progress. Though the mirrors tend to be better than talismans. This is a two-color thing, and I might be playing both colors. So, jeez, I don't even know. I've got Tree of Tales. Could splash Viridian Shaman. Viridian Shaman is absurd. I guess I have two Shatters and a Goblin Replica. I don't need Viridian Shaman. Okay. Let's probably take a Mirror, and I think I could take Leaden Mirror because I'll play Plains to play a Abunus, then have Leaden Mirror to enable my Skeleton Shard if I'm splashing that. Yeah, I think that sounds right. This pack has not a whole lot. Green is open, Fangman Hunter and Telgelot Archers, but probably it's going to take Nim Replica. Just good with Skeleton Shards, defined card in general. Alright, another Nim Replica. I could, at this point, take Necrogen Spell Bomb. I do like Spell Bombs in this deck. Alright. Because I have Mirror Enforcer, and I'm hoping to pick up one or two other cards like that. Alright, we bricked here. We're not playing any of these cards. I guess I'll take Consumed Spirit. The Cycle of Shards is so funny. Heartwood Shard is by far the worst. Pearl Shard, the white one's also very bad, but then the red, blue, and black ones are just insane. Just take Consume Spirit here. Also, might not even play Abunus. I don't even know. So, I'm playing red. I know I'm playing red. Like, I have this many cards without any cards except for just two Shatters and the activation on Goblin Replica with outs to play Abunus and or blue and or Morax Scavenger. Who knows? I'll take Lifespark Spellbomb now. I would quite like some more Mirror Enforcers. That would be nice. I guess I'll take Neem Lasher, even though I'm probably not playing that either. And I'm not going to wheel anything particularly good. World Slayer! This is a pretty funny card, but I'll take Steel Wall. That, again, that has its uses. And let's see what else we got here. Well, Nim Shrieker, on the other hand, is actually good. So that's a good late Nim Shrieker, and we could just be playing black here, like we planned initially. You get to fly over. You have, what, we have 3, 6, 7, 12, 30, 40, 15 artifacts going into pack 3. That is a pretty good amount. All right, another Spell Bomb. So we could definitely get there on the like mono, near mono black or red black affinity-ish deck. Another Spell Bomb, all right. Kind of wish I had not taken that Necrogen Spell Bomb over Nim Replica now, but that is but a small detail. And take Sphere of Purity, which is not a card. All right, what do we want pack 3? Triskelion, yes. Holy crap. Triskelion is insane, and with Skeleton Shard especially, and all right, we're definitely getting more Scavenger in the deck now. Over what? Silver Mirror, Cathodian? Psh, let's just take Triskelion before something happens and they take it away from us. Our precious Triskelion. What in the world? Pentavis? This card's also really good. It costs a lot of mana, but if you start moving the Pentavites off, this is a 5-5. You can remove a counter to make a 1-1 flyer, and then you can sack those flyers to put the counters back on. All right, let's move the curve over. We are Pentavising. Betrayal of Flesh, also very good. 6 mana, kill a creature, sack 3 lands to return a creature. Doesn't matter though. Goblin Replica doesn't matter. We are Pentavising. All right. We just want mirrors now. Quicksilver Elemental is good. 1 dozen eyes is not bad either, but I'm going to take Terror. Just cheap interaction is quite good now that I just picked up these two unbeatable late game bombs. Probably not playing the Abunus either anymore. At this point, we're just going to be red-black. Our card quality is just through the roof. And at this point, I'm not as interested in the spell bombs as I was. We might play some of them, but I'm going to try to just draft a more normal deck. And we'll see. If we pick up another Mirror Enforcer and a Frogmite or something, we could be back on the spell bomb train. But for right now, I'm interested in just playing like a slightly higher land count and just getting to 6 and 7 to play Pentavis and Triskelion. And, well, winning pretty easily, probably. All right, well, we'll pick up another broken card. Mirrodin Longbow, very, very good. Basically, if you have two creatures in play and you have this on one of them, you can shoot, move, shoot. It's just a common that just guns down their team. So I'm going to take that over Nurok Spy, Tree of Tales, and Whoa, Bringer. Whoa. Yeah, Longbow is great. I really just want to pick up more mirrors, but I'm just going to take Irradiate here over a bunch of nonsense since I've got enough artifacts that I think Irradiate is going to be good. I already have a Steel Wall that I'm probably not going to play. I could take another Shatter. 3 Shatters is kind of a lot. Consume Spirit, I already have one of those. I guess I'll just take another Shatter. That's fine. I'll play 3 Shatters. I'm not above that. And probably just start cutting the rando spell bombs at this point. Ooh, actually a bunch of decent playables here. Sign Out Sanctum is a card I think is underrated, or was underrated. I guess this is very old now. You can hide your Pentavis and Triskelion in there, or your Moriak Scavenger, just all your come-to-play ability cards. Another Radiate, don't really want that. Don't want another Spellbomb. I guess another Nim Replica is fine. I just want more creatures, and Nim Replica is just a decent one. Flayed Nim, this card's a little slow. Disciple of the Vault's actually pretty good with all the spell bombs, but I don't need to be aggressive. I've got such good late game. I mean, I could just take the Ancient Den if I want to play Abunus anyway, but I don't even think I want to play Abunus here. Just don't need to. I guess I'll take Ancient Den anyway, though. Vault of Whispers I will play, though. That one's nice. And Bottle Gnomes, that's also a nice one with Skeleton Shard. Nice little control deck here. Let's see. I need to cut a card or two. I guess I could cut Necrogen Spellbomb. And I want to cut one more. I want to play 17 lands, I think. I could cut Nimshrieker. It's just not what this deck is all about. I could cut Wizard Replica, actually. How many artifacts do I have right now? 3, 8, 9, 10, 11, 15, 16, 17. I'll have 18. Nah, that means Nimshrieker is pretty good, even with 17 artifacts. Could also cut both and just play another, like, random spell bomb or something. Yeah, I don't think I want to get the Consume Spirit plan going. I think I like just playing red for some Shatters and Pirate Spell Bomb and Goblin Replica. Rule of Law, why not? Cards. Another Steel Wall. Could play a Steel Wall. Where's Mirrodin Longbow? Last pick, Necrogen Spellbomb. All right, well, this deck does seem pretty busted. I actually think this is just how I'm going to build it. 17 land, 2 mirrors, 2 spellbombs. I guess, actually, Aether Spellbomb is not even better than Necrogen Spellbomb because it's even better than Wizard Replica. Maybe I'll just play Wizard Replica. I've got 2 great equipments. Yeah, let's just do that. Wizard Replica in, Aether Spellbomb out. The only thing I'm trying to enable is Irradiate and Nimshrieker, and I'm doing fine, and Mirror Enforcer, but I'm doing fine on those things. So, put in the Vault of Whispers. I'm not going to play the off-color artifact lands either, I don't think. If I had a blue one, I probably would, but it's just no reason to get mana screwed in a. Well, I actually can afford to, I think, take out a Swamp and play like a Tree of Tales. And I still don't want to play a Abunus, though, so I think this looks pretty great to me.